I request the Honorable Chancellor to deliver his presidential address.
Shri Ashank T. Desai, founder and former chairman, Mastek Limited. Dr. Satish R. Shetye, Vice Chancellor. Dr. V.P. Kamat, Registrar. Members of the Court, Executive Council, Academic Council, and other bodies of the university. Deans of faculties, principals of colleges, heads of departments, members of faculties, recipients of degrees, award winners, respected citizens of Goa, ladies and gentlemen, my dear students. It is with great pleasure and also a sense of deep satisfaction that I participate today in this 26th convocation of Goa University. This is an occasion of great joy and pride, not only for the students who are being conferred with degrees, but also for their families and friends. Let me first and foremost congratulate all the graduates, postgraduates, diploma holders who have received their degrees and diplomas today. I would also on this occasion particularly like to compliment all the award winners who have been recognized for their outstanding performance and for their pursuit of excellence. As you progress in life and take the challenges that lie ahead, you will remember this landmark day as an event that marked society's recognition of your ability to learn and your hard work and perseverance. I would also like to, at the outset, wish all the young students all the very best and a very bright future. I'm reminded of someone who said, and I quote, "A graduation ceremony is an event where the commencement speaker tells thousands of students dressed in identical caps and gowns that individuality is the key to success," unquote. This is something you need to remember at all times. We are indeed very happy, and I must say also deeply privileged, to have with us today Sri Ashank D. Desai, former chairman and managing director of Mastek Limited, an organization of world fame that he founded. To the citizens of this state, he is a proud son of Goa who symbolizes the entrepreneurial spirit that is very much desirable to tap the opportunity that a world connected with high technology systems offers. In him, we see the neighborhood boy who grew up in the midst of the then modest academic institutions existing in the state and went on to excel from institutions outside the state, primarily due to sheer dint of hard work, perseverance, tenacity, and excellence. He thereafter went on to establish organizations that today dot the globe, providing services by using state-of-the-art technologies. He has therefore brought laurels not only to Goa, but to our country as well, and I'm sure all Goans can bask in his reflected glory. To the graduating class of today, Sri Ashank D. Desai therefore personifies both a challenge and the great inspiration to meet this challenge. Goa University could not have found a better person to exemplify the spirit of "Yes, we can," a spirit that we all hope will help our state and our country to grab the opportunity the globalized world of today offers to us Indians. It is a matter of great pride and privilege to have such a person address our graduates on the day that marks the commencement of the stage when they have to face the challenging world firsthand. I extend a very warm welcome to Sri Ashank D. Desai on this campus of Goa University. Only last month, I had the very pleasant opportunity of honoring his revered mother in the remote taluka of Kankona. On this important day, I would like to say that the state of Goa can justifiably be proud of what it has achieved since liberation in the field of higher education. It is satisfying and encouraging that 1/3 of the eligible young women and men in the state entered the field of higher education. In our country as a whole, less than 1/5 of those eligible enjoy the privilege of higher education. An occasion like the convocation of the state's only university is therefore not only the right occasion to rejoice on the access to higher education that the state has been able to achieve, but also an occasion to pledge ourselves to raising the numbers even further. For me, today is also an occasion when I can share my dreams and concerns in respect of the future of our university with a cross-section of the citizens who are intimately associated with higher education in the state. While Goa has achieved a high rate of enrollment in the higher education sector, it is my cherished dream that Goa University should match this high level of access to education with an equally high quality of education and become a university that can serve as a role model for other state universities. Being a small university, the potential for raising standards and achieving excellence is very much there. Goa University, however, must keep in mind that it has to serve the bulk of the students of the state and not cater to only the most gifted ones. The university must constantly aim at lifting the standard and level of the student population as a whole and not just the ones with a consistently high performance. I truly believe that Goa University is ideally suited to take on the challenge of turning itself into a model university for three critical reasons. Firstly, the state of Goa has happily shown a willingness to invest in higher education by maintaining a healthy level of support consistently during the last few decades. In fact, per capita expenditure on higher education in Goa for the age group 18 to 23 is the highest amongst all states in the country. Secondly, the number of students in the university, about 27,000 at present, and the number of affiliated colleges, 50 and odd, are well within manageable limits. Thirdly, the government of the state has shown willingness to respond constructively to well-founded requests for administrative support. In view of these three factors, the scope of turning Goa University into a role model and a center for excellence is very much there, and it is for all of us together to work towards that end. We owe it to the youth of the state. What is needed is a frequent and continuous, honest evaluation of all ongoing practices with a burning desire to introduce changes that make up for the lacunae that emerge from the evaluation. The process of evaluation and updating must form an integral part of the culture and ethos of the university and its associated institutions and should be taken up and done with a sense of deep commitment and passion. To my mind, a major and critical element that needs strengthening in our university education system is to inculcate among our students the much-needed ability to innovate. Simply put, it is the ability to think on one's feet, to design, produce, and deliver products that are needed by different components of society, including employers, government, organizations, and entrepreneurs. The absence of encouragement, or may I say, lack of ability amongst our student community to think on his or her own, particularly while pursuing higher education, is perhaps a national malaise. Goa University, I am convinced, is better placed than all others to address this issue successfully and better than all others for reasons I just outlined. It is therefore our bounden duty to try and promote and inculcate such a culture that would boost and champion innovation. The university needs to give high priority and focus its attention to addressing this issue. I suggest the university should strengthen its internal and external mechanisms that require a student to do independent thinking. I would like to suggest a three-tier approach to this concept. At the undergraduate level, we need to strengthen the practice of preparing project reports. This is perhaps the first opportunity or stage a student gets to put his or her own stamp on a product of intellectual endeavor. The students could even use the internet to make these project reports accessible globally. Secondly, it is essential to make dissertation necessary for any postgraduate degree. The dissertations too should become accessible through the internet. Thirdly, and very importantly, we need to strengthen doctoral programs by using and following the University Grants Commission guidelines, both in letter and spirit. Doctoral programs, as you are well aware, are the backbone of research in any university. Goa University must therefore strengthen its doctoral programs if it really wishes to make its mark as a place for research or a center for excellence. The main campus of the university must take a lead in this direction, though the colleges will also need to build up this culture of innovation. In fact, only after we take action on the first two tiers will we be able to achieve real success in the third tier. I would, however, like to emphasize that the three initiatives that I have just outlined will require strong and constant support from the faculty for their successful implementation. I'm sure that the teaching staff in our colleges and on the university's main campus will rise to the occasion to take up this challenge. You owe it to the state that has so generously supported you and your profession. You also, more importantly, owe it to the future younger generation of the state. I would like to reiterate by saying that our teaching community, that if you do not deliver on this count, you will in a way mar the progress of our great country. In addition to the steps that I have mentioned, which I feel are required to be taken to imbibe in our graduates a culture of independent thinking and creativity, the university, I feel, would do well if it were to consider introduction of internships in its programs. This would entail considerable cooperation from organizations that are well beyond the control and outside the university system, that is, those from the private sector, the public sector, and government. Such cooperation, I feel, will in fact be a hallmark of a university, particularly if the university happens to be the only university of the state. I'm sure all our stakeholders would agree that the university is much too important an entity for the state of Goa to be left to fend for itself. To my mind, there should be a frequent and constant interaction between the components of the university and the elements of society at large. Most critically important in this regard is the need for a constant interaction between the university and the industry in Goa. The most recent step taken by the Goa University to keep its syllabi on its website is a welcome step, not only towards openness, but also towards enlarging and enabling the scrutiny of the university by professional bodies and even members of the public. More such steps are required to be taken to make the system transparent and open to independent evaluation. This will only be beneficial for the health of the university. In the absence of such scrutiny, decision-making and functioning within a university, I feel, has the danger of turning insular and regressive. This needs to be avoided at all costs. The media, I feel, has an important role to play in bringing Goan society closer to Goa University and in enlarging and broad-basing the interaction between the two. I must in this regard compliment the local media for its extensive coverage of the visiting research professorship program that the university launched recently. I found the coverage of the program both informative and constructive. While the university surely needs more such coverage and reporting, what is also needed is more questioning and debate on the expectations of the state and its people from the university. These expectations, I feel, could cover a wide range of activities from educational programs that the state expects the university to launch to the number of seats that need to be made available in the different disciplines, or even the fees that the university should charge from its students. I sincerely hope the media will enthusiastically and objectively play this role, thereby acting as a catalyst to enlarge the interaction between the people of the state and their sole university. To our graduates on this most important day, I would like to cite R.W. Emerson, who said, and I quote, "Do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail," unquote. Someone very succinctly said, "The best of all things is to learn. Money can be lost or stolen. Health and strength may fail, but what you have committed to your mind is yours forever." This is something our students must never forget. Before concluding, let me quote what Tom Brokaw, the American TV anchorman, said to the graduates from a university, and I quote, "You are educated. Your certification is in your degree. You may think of it as the ticket to the good life. Let me ask you to think of an alternative. Think of it as your ticket to change the world," unquote. I wish the graduating class of today all the best as you take on your chosen challenge and path. May your path be blessed. Thank you. Jai Hind.